What the heck? Okay. Now we gotta go.
Hey guys, Rexter here, and welcome to today's random horror game, Lilith's Curse 1984. It is a found footage-styled first-person horror survival game where we need to escape an abandoned sewage system while these monsters come and attack us. Now, guys, if you enjoy games like this, do me a big favor, go ahead and smash that like button. The like goal for this video is 150 likes, and I know we can absolutely crush that if you just stop what you're doing and hit that like button right now. Also, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. I promise you won't regret it, and if you do, you can always unsubscribe. But without further ado, let's jump into this, guys. By the way, this is just a beta, so there might be a couple bugs and things like that. We're just gonna, you know, trial it, see if we actually want to play the full version of the game when this is all said and done. And guys, do me a big favor, if you guys do want to see the full version of the game, just comment down below Lilith 1984. All right, so I guess we got a nice little opening cutscene here. Shows like the developer studios, things like that. 1984, Lilith's Curse. Hey, I wish we got a little bit, I hope at least, that we get a little bit of a backstory, because why would we end up just in a random sewage system with a camera? And what, to me, it's just a little odd, right? Like, how do these characters put themselves in these situations to begin with? Because I've never, in my 27 years of living, just ended up in a cage in a sewer. Just saying. Have any of you guys? If you have, let me know. But I don't think this is a normal occurrence, so I would love a backstory. It's just a demo, right? So we can't be too picky. Okay, but I kind of like the style of the game. Kind of PS1-ish, it looks like. Colors look good. And it's not as dark as I thought it was going to be, which is a huge bonus. I think games like this tend to be a little too dark at times, but these lamp lights seem to be helping. So, all right. Looks like we are stuck in a cage. There's a bunch of bones around. Looks like a couple of other people have been here as well and didn't get as lucky as we are to just have our cage be completely unlocked. I don't know how we got so lucky, but okay. Remember how I said it was bright? And it looks a little darker than it did before. So, okay, it's completely dark. You can't see anything over here. I mean, other than this, which I'm assuming is lit up because this is where we need to go. So press R to use the camera, and then we got tab. Find the battery and find the exit key. Okay, and R to use the camera. Do we have a flashlight by chance? No. Wait, it looks like something is toggling, but maybe we need the battery. That's probably why it's not working. Okay, what? Why is the ambience changing? Why did it sound like somebody was approaching? All right, I'm gonna go back this way, because I can't really see anything else, which I'm assuming is for a reason. So, can I go through here? No. Okay, well, this is very, very dark, but oh, okay, actually, maybe the whole point is to look through the camera lens, because it's a little, nope, it's bad. It's just really bad to see. Wait, over there, there's some light. I mean, at this point, there could be monsters, creatures, follow the signs. Oh, okay, so we are supposed to use the camera. Don't come after. Help. Okay, that's mixed signals here. Don't come after me, but help me? How does that make sense to you? Oh, here we go, more signs. That one is just scribble. Something's in front of me here. Uh-oh. A lot of scribble here. I don't know. I hope this is not like a blacklight camera where you could see things that would be inappropriate. Wait, I'm stuck here now. I don't see any more signs. Oh, here we go. So this is kind of unique, I guess, right? You can... Oh, those look like handprints. This is kind of unique, I guess, in the fact that, you know, you have to use your camera to actually see things, but at the same time, you literally can't see much. Like, right now, I'm just guessing. Okay, not that way. What? Is the water getting deeper, or is it just me? I feel like I'm barely above the water. Okay, now we're stuck. We're just stuck here, floating. Yeah, I don't like this, guys. I'm gonna just go ahead and knock it off 2 points just for the fact that what the heck is happening? What? What? I was supposed to take this off? No. Yeah, I guess so. Aha, okay. Maybe it's my fault. I guess we were supposed to take off the camera, even though I wish it would have said something. Here we go. All right, we're making some progress now.
So I'm looking for a camera battery, which might be right here. Odd to me that we found a camera just in the bottom of a sewage system, but that's why these games are fictional. Why can't I pick this up? There we go. Press F for night vision mode. Perfect. Okay. What's the point of a game without night vision mode on a camera, right? An analog style horror game. All right, so I can't crouch, so I don't think we go this way. I don't think so. Maybe. No? Okay. Let's keep moving then. There's a lot to explore now that we got our night vision. Also, there could be... I mean, I'm still waiting for some type of monster to pop. Up. What the heck was that? And where did it go? Okay. Well, that was... Yeah, that was pretty creepy, huh? Okay, now we've got these empty caskets. Okay, and an axe. Can I use it? Oh, nice. Can I swing it is the question. How do you swing? How do you swing this bad boy? Oh, whoa. Okay, maybe you can't? What's the point of having an axe if I can't swing it? Anything else? No. Okay. So now we've got a useless axe that you can't swing. Oh, you know what? It might be to knock down wooden planks like this. Yeah, there we go. Okay, but that's not going to help us when that creature comes back. That thing was crazy looking, too. It was really well done, so... Hello? What? What the heck? Oh, my God. Why isn't he attacking me, though? That's weird. Okay, I can't cut this one down. That's weird. They're, like, playing with me. They're not attacking. Hello? What's this? Is this the exit key? Nice. And photo memory saved. Okay. Oh, we got a new tab here. Exit coordinates. Ah, okay. So... Oh, man. We got to actually follow these. Okay. What's happening? Holy crap! Am I dead? Oh my God, I'm dead here. I'm dead. They're gonna... Okay. They have the memory of a goldfish? What's happening here? How did they not see me walk into the casket? And what are they doing out there? They're just sloshing around. Do you guys mind leaving? Is it safe to go out? I don't know if it's safe to go. Should I just do it anyways? Why would you turn around to look down? What? Hey, well, they're gone for now. Uh-oh. Thought I heard a growl there. Okay, let's keep moving then. So can I cut this, or how else would we get past? Guess not. Oh, we still gotta follow these coordinates, so let's go ahead and take them out. So this is actually going away from them, so I think we gotta go back. So 18148. I feel like this would be going negative. Yeah, this is negative, so it is this way. Alright, well, I guess we gotta figure out how exactly we're gonna get through this. Let's see. Maybe it's like one of those games where you press down on this little lamp thing. Was there supposed to be a cutscene here? Oh no. Maybe I can walk past this after all? I don't know. We gotta figure this out. Oh, this is a ladder. This whole time I thought this was a bookshelf. Thank God it said press E, because I would have been walking around that sewer for hours. Okay, guess not that way. Let's continue to follow these coordinates, even though... Yeah, I think we should. Yeah, I think we should go that way. Because the first coordinate seems to be going up this way, so... We need to at least get to 18. No, this is the way we came up, no? Let me see. Yep. No. Wait. Okay, no, yeah, we get down here. Okay, it's just to get past the wall, I think. We just drop in. Okay. So we're really close now to the exit. We're like at 17. So we're like one coordinate off from 18. I don't know too much about latitude and longitude, but I feel like that makes sense. Okay. Up we go. See if we can find any tools or anything. All right, two doors, but I don't think... I should really just stick to the plan of following the coordinates. But wait, they're going down. Hold on. Pull out the... Wait, my thing is gone. Oh, another hiding spot. Okay. That means something's in here with me. What the heck is that? What did I just pick up? More coordinates? Weird. So it's like coordinates... like, what would these be to? I mean, I'm just gonna follow where I have yet to go, which would be this way. Thank God. So you don't run out of stamina, which is nice. So you don't have to, like, the heck, so bright. Oh my God, there's footsteps on the ground. Okay, nothing's in here with me though, so I think we're okay. Can't pick up any of these books, right? Piano? Play the piano? Okay. Now maybe we go back to the coordinates? 9.6. It wouldn't be this way. Unless some type of secret passageway opens. No? Okay. Negative? Wait. That's weird. It's gotta be this way. 9.6. Like right here. 9.6. 9.6. 6.6. Says it's like... Oh, and then 25. No? This way? Yeah, it says it's like right here. What are these coordinates to? That's weird. It's like to this pole. Or maybe to this. Oh, there's a key. Okay. Uh-oh. There's somebody breathing. Heavily. Is there something in here with me? Where'd the footsteps go? What the? Are you guys getting this? What the heck? Okay, now we gotta go. Okay. So I was kind of wondering where the jump scares were, and now I regret asking. That was a good one. That was definitely a good jump scare. And I know it got you guys as well, so don't even play like it didn't. We gotta get to 31.6, but the problem is... That creature blocked us off. Right? Can we go back through here? I don't think so. Unless we can... No, we can't cut through. Alright, so we're gonna have to find a new way around. Dude, that was a good one. I am not even gonna front. That was a good jump scare. Okay, so this one is not a ladder? Is that what I'm getting here? Can't climb up that. Okay. So it looks like we're gonna have to backtrack to get back over there somehow. We also have this key, which I'm assuming is to the exit, obviously, but... Oh, I forgot about the empty caskets. Something might be down here with us. We gotta keep our eyes out. Another one there. Okay, here we go. No? Interesting. We gotta go all the way down? Did I just hear something? Aha, okay. Oh, this is what the keys were for, to these doors. Okay, let's see, do we need anything in here? No. Okay, so the first door was completely useless. Maybe we get something in this one? Oh yeah, here we go. 31. There's gotta be a key or something here. A letter. It says warning. Warning from what? What, did that chair just move? I don't have any coordinates. Oh. Ooh. Oh my God! Something just knocked all that down. Okay, I can't jump, so I think we have to go out there. we die? I think we died. Did we beat it? I have a lot of questions here. Oh yeah, I guess we beat the demo because it's a Filipino horror game. Solo developer Ken Lloyd. Alright Ken, well you made yourself one heck of a demo, that's for sure. I actually was pretty captivated by the gameplay. And the jump scare really did get me, guys. I don't know about you. Maybe you guys are a little more brave than I am, but that one got me. I was not expecting that at all. So thank you guys, honestly, for all of the support. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, go ahead and smash that like button. Remember to comment down below, Lilith's Curse 1984. And yeah, we'll come back with the full version of this game for sure when it comes out. It has a full story mode, so I'm excited to check it out. Anyways, I'm going to wrap up here. Thank you guys again for all of the support, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Until then, peace out!